Morning, gents. How you doing? Hope you're good. Tuesday morning. Slowly starting to wind down for Christmas. But not before we do day 18. So day 18 is about tracking your calories and nutrition, taking into 2019. Now, there are lots and lots of things that go wrong with nutrition. Lazy habits, lack of preparation, taking the easiest route, poor patterns that lead to poor nutrition. We're not tracking our calories. So the first thing you need to do is if you're looking for fat loss, it's be at a deficit. Okay, you need to be at a calorie deficit. All right, and how to work that out is, the best way that we do it is going to Google, type in TDEE, total daily energy expenditure. Put in your details, that will work out for you, your maintenance calories. Now, I usually say anything between sort of 10 and 20% for fat loss. And the key thing here is to be able to track and manage your calories. So I would say go a 15% deficit. And then you need to record your calories, all right? So whatever number you come up with for your daily calorie target, you need to times that by 7. Now, I would normally run your calorie target from a Friday to a Friday. And that is because usually at the weekend, we're completely out of fuckwits with the way that we eat. Now, over a 7-day period, let's say 2,000 calories, that's what, 14,000 calories you have over a 7-day period. Now, imagine you have £2,000 to spend each day. That's £14,000 you have to spend in 7 days. So the key here is not to overspend across the week. So what you have to do is budget your calories, i.e. your money. All right, so over the weekend, you tend to spend more money because you're not in a solid routine. All right, you're not in a routine. You're out with family, you're out with friends, you're socializing, and you tend to spend more, and you tend to consume more calories. Make sense so far? So if you're going along, it's Saturday night, you've got loads of things going on, you probably, let's say you have 3,500 calories, and then the same for Sunday. Let's say you have another 3,500 calories. Now that is 3,000 calories over your target. You've overspent £3,000 over the weekend. Remember, your budget was 2,000, you spent 3,500, okay, over the 2 days, that's an extra 3,000. Now, you've got from Monday to Friday to claw some of that back, all right? So what you then have to do is figure out how many calories you have left. So you've spent 7,000, you've in theory got 7,000 calories left over 5 days, and you have to do the maths. I can't do the maths off the top of my head this time in the morning. You then do the maths and work out what your new calorie target is between Monday and Friday. You see, it's not just what you achieve in a day when it comes to your calorie targets. It's over a period of 7 days, over a period of 4 weeks. Now, what I like to do is keep people on that same calorie deficit over a 4-week period. And at the start of that process of you starting to track your calories, I'd recommend that you measure yourself. Take around your waist. Take a before picture, your front, the side of your body, and the back. And keep a food journal. Now, keeping a food journal allows you to look at some of the bad patterns that you are keeping when it comes to nutrition, okay? You can write stuff down as like, you at the end of each day, you can write down what you've eaten, you can put your mood next to it, and it becomes very common and apparent what type of mood you're in when you eat and drink the wrong things. And then suddenly you start seeing a pattern of that when you're coming home and you're stressed and you're just picking, or you're drinking beer, or you're eating the kids' leftovers, or when you're on a trip somewhere and you haven't made your lunch because you haven't planned and prepped properly, so you end up going into McDonald's and eating shit calories. All right, so keep it a food journal, keep it before and after picture, track your calories like on an Excel sheet or something, or in a notepad, keep a track of your calories. And at the end of the 4 weeks, assess whether you're moving forwards. Take more before and after pictures. Take your after pictures, take your measurements, record it all. See whether you're feeling hungry, feeling whether you're lethargic and tired. If you are, then maybe you're on a little bit less, your calories are a little bit too low. Maybe you just need a couple more to build up that energy. So there's lots of factors, but that's just keeping it very, very basic. You know, I'm trying to keep it simplistic as possible. when you track stuff, you manage it. So like if you run a business or you're a manager or you run a budget, you will very much look at the numbers consistently, right? What is your weekly income? What's your weekly outgoings? It should be no different with your calories. It's just exactly the same. There's an app that you can do it. You simply plug in, morning Craig, morning Scott, you simply plug in your details, right, to MyFitnessPal. That is like your balance, your profit and loss sheet, your calories in and out. All you got to do is put the thing that you've eaten in there and it'll tell you how many calories. All you have to do even now is just scan it and it will tell you. So it's not hard work, it's just practice. And it's just a pattern that you need to get into so that you can continue tracking your food and monitoring. If you say that to me, if I say to you, how's your nutrition? And you go, oh yeah, it's that side of things are all right. And I say to you, okay, so how many calories are you eating a day? Okay, how much are you tracking? How much alcohol are you drinking a week? Okay, and you say to me, well, you know, I know that I'm eating chicken, broccoli and rice. Fuck off. You need to track, you need to manage. Honestly, if you don't track and manage your nutrition, how the fuck can you know whether you're doing well or not? So, there's that side of things. Then there is getting into the habit, into the pattern of planning your food, planning ahead, okay? A lot of the problem is that a lot of people don't plan, so what they end up doing is taking quick options, meal deals at Tesco's, which is all right every now and then, don't get me wrong, but like all of the time, we want to be getting some good nutrients in us, okay? We want to be eating good calories, we want to be eating fruit, we want to be drinking plenty of water. Okay, I know that we're trying to keep within our calories, but they've got to at least be good calories. Okay, and it's not the fucking end of the world if you can't, if you have a snack, a nice treat every now and then, as long as within your calories, as long as you're tracking it and managing it and not being a complete nut fuckwit and just eating McDonald's every breakfast, every lunch, and then a KFC for dinner. Okay, you have to be sensible. You have to show common sense as you go into 2019. So you're planning and prepping. If you plan in your planning and prepping, guess what? You're gonna figure it in there. You manage your meetings, you manage your date nights, you manage your workouts. Why wouldn't you manage 20 minutes to cook up a ton of food to take with you, like a little packed lunch, like you used to at school, okay, out with you to work? That way you can save money by not spending it in fucking fast food restaurants or Tesco's meal deals. Trying to save money, if you're struggling for money, then go and buy it in bulk from Aldi. It will be a much, much cheaper option for you, okay? And it's all within your house, because what you do is you go off and you buy all your shopping, but then you go and buy all of your other stuff as well. So then you spend all your money in the shopping, and then you're spending all your money like on the road or out, which is, and then you say, I can't continue this anymore because I can't afford it. And you're just like, you can't afford the gym membership because you can't afford it. Well, look at what you could save if you planned and prepped, all right? So, small wins going into 2019 is to start tracking your food, your ins and your outs, okay? Start planning in and factoring in planning and preparation time for your food. Start keeping a journal, okay? Make sure you take before and after pictures before you start tracking so that you can see the visualization of whether this is working for you. Remember, you're not gonna achieve the world in 4 weeks. Don't expect to have a six pack and look like the finished article, guys, in 4 weeks. It's gonna take months. It's gonna probably take you up to 6 to 8 months, okay, to sustain a routine over a long period of time. Not just a 4 weeks, that's it, and then, all right, let's get fucking back on it. Fuck it off, it worked, I don't need to continue. All right, sustainability is the key. Getting into a pattern of doing this, routine, making it a lifestyle. All right, guys, so listen, have a great week. I'll catch you tomorrow, hump week. Just think a week today, it's Christmas. Have fun.